Good afternoon, people. Watch Woman 65, Lisa Boyce. I'm going to give you the gospel. It's in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. Christ shed his blood for all of our sins, past, present, and future, was buried and rose again on the third day, according to scripture. We're saved by grace through faith in Christ alone, not of ourselves, not of works, not of anything. It's just grace through faith in Christ alone. Not of ourselves, not of works, lest anybody should boast, any man should boast. It is grace, something we didn't earn, something we don't deserve, that God gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe, that's the key word, believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. I've heard people say in the past it's more to it than just believing. What else is there? Oh, you have to do this, you got to do, no, no. Whosoever, keyword, believe in him will not perish but have eternal life. How do you come to that? You admit you're a sinner in need of Christ. You put your faith and trust in him, accept him as Savior, and you're saved, rapture ready, justified by the blood of Jesus, and sealed until the day of redemption, which means you will not lose your salvation, period. Once saved, always saved. The Holy Spirit will indwell in you. The Holy Spirit will lead you, guide you. He's your best friend, and the Holy Spirit will change you. Things are happening. Things are happening fast. And you need to think about how quick you're going to be raptured. Think about this for a second. Now, and when I was watching the movie Top Gun Maverick, which was, by the way, amazing to me. I was thinking about when he was going at Mach 10 in the beginning with that plane. And I'm thinking, you know, I think of all this stuff, even watching movies like this, I think of, wow, just think the rapture is going to be even at a greater speed than that. Say Mach 100, because at the blink of an eye, you're gonna be in front of the Lord. That's incredible. I can't wait. You should be excited for that. I am. I got this off of Prophecy News Watch, and it says it's the United Nations, the final beast system of the end times. I would say absolutely, positively, yes. At the summit, it says at the summit for the future in 2023, the UN, together with civil society, now this is 2023, the UN, together with civil society and the private sector, are expected to agree on shared principles for an open, free, and secure digital future for all. Now tell me, we've got to be out of here soon. This right here is happening next year. This includes promoting a trustworthy internet with accountability criteria for discrimination and misleading content, as well as regulating artificial intelligence to be consistent with our shared global values. However, what this means in practice is that the values must correlate with the beliefs held sacred. Listen to this. Listen very carefully. By the United Nations and the World Economic Forum. In other words, the Ministry of Trust. Now you tell me this is not the stage for the Antichrist. This is supposed to happen in 2023. I feel that we are going to be gone by the end of the year. Could I be wrong? Yeah, I'm human. But I really don't think the church is going to be here much longer. There's an earthquake in Alaska right now. Not a big one. But I'm going to tell you what happened with Alaska shortly. And it's involving Russia. This goes on to say, this Secretary General Antonio Guterres writes in our common agenda that one of the risks of the fourth industrial revolution is the use of digital surveillance and manipulation to influence behavior and control populations. The very legitimate concern, however, is more about the fact that the UN does not want this technology to fall into the hands of forces that they themselves or their partners do not control. This is because the whole idea, listen very carefully, the whole idea behind the Global Digital Compact is to be able to control the world's population and align its values to be in line with the UN's and the World Economic Forum interpretations of the 17 global goals of Agenda 2030. This is why they don't want 45 back in office. And this is why they're pulling out every stop they can to stop him. To stop him. This is the anti-crisis agenda. This is telling me right now we're not going to be here much longer. One such example is the seventh commitment in our common agenda is about improving digital collaboration through the creation of a global digital compact. That means that all people should be connected. Listen, this is when I read this, I got excited because I know we're not going to be here. Listen to this. This means that all people should be connected to the internet, that liability criteria for discrimination and misleading content should be developed, that artificial intelligence should be regulated, and the establishment of the digital commons as a digital public good. However, the whole thing is more comprehensive than that. By extension, this constitutes the construction of a digital world brain intended to regulate and control all human life to keep it within the planetary boundaries. This is mind-boggling right here. The commitment is one of the more central ones, and it's about creating a consensus on the need for total digitization. This builds on the recommendations made in the report, The Age of Digital Interdependence in 2019 by the UN High Level Panel on Digital Cooperation led by Melinda Gates. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And Jack Ma from the Alibaba Group, and in collaboration with actors such as the World Economic Forum and their Center for the Fourth Industrial Revolution. Another example is the Initiative Coalition for Digital Environmental Sustainability, which is called CODES, which is formed after the launching of the UN Roadmap for Digital Cooperation in March 2021, with the aim of promoting digital sustainability. The coalition currently gathers around 1,000 stakeholders from more than 100 countries. CODES, Coalition for Digital Environmental Sustainability, works to implement collective system changes and remove any obstacles standing in the way of the total digitization that they believe is needed to implement the sustainability goals. Folks, the church can't be here for this. The church cannot be here for this. Because God said in Revelation 3:10, I will remove you from that which is about to overtake the entire world. Here's another interesting article too. I just got this. This is from the World Economic Advisor himself. And he just said, global elite don't need the vast majority of the population to live. The World Economic Forum regularly calls for the mass extermination of human beings. You see what's going on, right? So what's going to happen, and I'm going to say this, when the rapture of the church happens, first they're going to wonder what the hell happened to all these people. Millions of people all of a sudden disappeared from worldwide off the face of the planet. Second, they're going to figure out where the blame game is. They're going to blame it on alien, anything from aliens to disease, whatever they're going to blame it on. Next, they're going to be glad that it happened. They're going to say it's a mass disappearance. They're going to say it's a mass death or whatever. But they're, you know what's going to be interesting? How are they going to explain the way the graves that are going to be open? That would be interesting. We're not going to be here for that, but that would be interesting how they're going to do that. They're going to say it was needed because the earth needed to cleanse itself from all the all these negative. They would say that we were negative people. Folks, it's coming. It's coming. I mean, this is so set up for the Antichrist right now. It is coming. During the environmental conference of June, this past June, CODES presented its action plan, which aims to inform about the priorities included in the global digital compact. In order to deal with the negative environmental and social effects of from energy use, greenhouse gases, material use, consumption, digital divides, violations, and incorrect information. Don't forget. That puts us a target on us. If we were still here for that. I really don't believe we're going to be here for this. I could be wrong, but I doubt it. I really doubt it. This is so close to the Antichrist, it's not even funny. And if we're this close to the Great Tribulation and the Antichrist, how much closer is the rapture? Comparing companies, greenhouse gas emissions, and that digital product passports be introduced with the aim of being able to follow a product's entire life cycle. The latter is the part of this circular economy and will eventually also be used on humans. Why do you think they're launching all these satellites? It is a new ecosystem in the making where everything is to be connected in order to measure degree of sustainability. A world brain that analyzes and keeps track of everything and everyone. Among the examples of how problems with incorrect information should be handled, Facebook's Climate Science Center is highlighted. The climate issue is the cornerstone of the agenda. As of the Paris Agreement 2015, the science is considered to be settled and no more debate or nuance in this field is to be tolerated. Again, why do you think all of this is going on? And if you look at my Telegram account, you're going to find out something else too. The spread of misinformation about planetary sustainability topics such as climate change, biodiversity, loss of pollution can undermine collective action and trust in its institutions, as well as magnify polarization and mistrust between divided groups. This is insane. This goes on to say, instead, incorrect information on the web must be corrected, and visitors instead provided with the United Nations verified climate information. It says it right there. On the website, they write that 2/3 of carbon dioxide emissions are linked to human consumption, and that they will creatively leverage technology and partnerships to increase green awareness and green actions among 1 billion green digital champions worldwide by the year 2025. 2025. We're in 2022, 23, 24. Oh, that's 3 years from now. Again, we've got to be gone soon. The citizens who, according to the Green Digital Finance Alliance, want immediate change should be encouraged to make climate smart choices through a rating. Through a rating system. Again, why was Sister Nasty? Why was Sister Nasty over there? Don't think for a moment she wasn't in touch with China. She was. Of course she was. Every purchase is registered and addressed according to the climate benefit. In this way, the necessary behavioral changes is achieved, will be achieved. It should come as no surprise that the founders behind the Green Digital Finance Alliance also helped develop the Chinese social credit system. Apparently, the Chinese system might just be a precursor to what is planned on a global scale. Again, Sister Nasty wasn't there just to be there. She's implementing this as well. Oh, this is much higher than we can ever think or imagine. So, Bible prophecy scholars have long examined the connection between the United Nations quest for a global world order and the system of the beast described in the book of Revelation. The current plans by the UN would certainly seem to provide a pathway to many of the systems that will be in place as described in the times we're in right now, called the end times. In what might have been an anonymous sign of things to come, in December of 2021, that's Delilah, a statue was placed outside the United Nations building in New York City that caused a lot of buzz in the Christian community for its imagery. The image looked like a kind of lion or leopard with wings and a rainbow-toned coloring. The art piece is said to be a guardian of international peace and security. Interesting. Several passages of scripture has been associated with the guardian of peace and security. The statue that was at the UN building. Daniel 7:24 relates a vision of beasts representing governments. One is depicted with a body like a lion and wings like an eagle. Revelation 13:2 symbolically refers to a beast being given power and authority by Satan. 1 Thessalonians 5:3 speaks of the latter days when people will say, there is peace and security, only to experience unexpected disaster. The statue resembling end times images erected at the headquarters of the world governing body, named with the phrase directly tied to the end times, makes you wonder if it is more than a coincidence, because it definitely, definitely, definitely was not a coincidence. The UN Global Digital Compact is clearly a stealth plan to track everyone with and everything with climate scores. I will say this again. Nasty, Sister Nasty, wasn't there just for cheering on Taiwan. The UN, I'm going to read this I'm going to read this sentence again. The UN Global Digital Compact is clearly a stealth plan to track everyone and everything with climate scores in the name of the, listen to this, the greater good. Remember that Left Behind movie? Oh, let's do it for the greater good. The greater good. Many climate activists would like to see the green revolution become the green religion where we put climate worship above everything else. They're doing it now. It's happening now. Again, I reiterate, why do you think they're doing what they're doing to 45? The UN has even used Agenda 21 and the Millennium Development Goals to divide the Earth into 10 regional groupings or spheres of influence to help administer climate goals. Revelation warned that in the last days, the beast system will have control over 10 kings, nations, and powers. The UN has one person, a security general who administers the powers of the UN. While this position has been fairly powerless in times past, that's going to change. Because the future leader and the head of the United Nations will be the Antichrist, and is coming sooner rather than later. In a nutshell, the plan is for all human life to be regulated by the UN. Just look at their own documents. The UN, the United Nations, is the final beast system. Indeed. I'm going to link this article in the description box. And I will be back later with more. Again, I have some articles on my blog that you're going to want to look at. And again, I will be back later. Thank you.